Now, practice exercise C talks about subsets, power sets, and cardinality of the power set. But we can always reverse the operation. We can always start with the cardinality of the power set. Okay. Since we already have the formula for the cardinality of the power set, we have 2 to the power of n, which wherein n means the number of elements in the given set. We have H, A, R, and D. So you have 4 elements. So the cardinality of the power set is 2 to the power of 4, which is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is equal to 16. In short, we need to get 16 subsets of set H containing letters H, A, R, and D. And we need to come up with a set containing all of the 16 for our power set. So how do we write subsets? As we define subsets in our module as a set which contains n elements of the given set. So if we have a given set, set H, containing letters H, A, R, and D, we can create subsets of this by first choosing single elements, or in short, we are going to make unit sets. Okay, so this is, again, 16 is the cardinality. We need to determine first the subsets, and using those subsets, create the power set. So first, we're going to use the unit sets. You have set containing H. Unit meaning one element. In this case, one letter. Next, set containing A. And then set containing R. And then finally, set containing D. So these are the first 4 subsets of the given set. We have the sets containing only one element, or the unit sets, H, A, R, and D. Since we are done with the unit sets, let us proceed to the other subsets containing 2 elements. So let us try to make it systematically. Let's pair first the first 2 letters, H and A. Separate it with a comma. Okay. Another, H, the first and the third letter, R. And then the first and the fourth letter. Okay. Next pair of elements. Okay. If you will write here, let's say A, H as your next pair, this set is just the same as the first set. A, H, set containing A and H, is just an equal set of a set containing H and A. It's just rearranged. In short, do not write anymore this set because they are just counted once. So these 2 do not belong to the 16. Only 1 belongs to the 16 subsets. So how do we continue this one? We need to pair the second element, A, to the third. The second to the fourth. And finally, the third and the fourth. Again, if you will try comparing all of these, please make sure that you are not writing equal sets because they are just counted once. So we have already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But we need to have 16 subsets. So how do we write the 16 subsets? After sets containing 1, sets containing 2 elements, let's go to sets containing 3 elements. So you have H, A, and R. And then H, A, make sure to separate with a comma, D. You have H, R, and D. And finally, you have A, R, D. So these are the next four. So 14. But we still lack two subsets. If we're going to proceed to the next number of elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, we will just return to the original set. But original set, or the set itself, is also a subset of that set. The symbol used to denote subsets are these two. The first symbol is to denote proper subsets. These are the symbols to be used in describing the first 14 types of sets. As for the set itself, we are going to use the second symbol. Okay? Now, it's now 15. We still need one more. Aside from the set itself, the last type of subset is the empty set or the null set. So these are the 16 subsets of set H. So once we determine the subsets, we can write the power set. To write power set, we simply write the symbol P, open parenthesis, H, and then close parenthesis. This is read as the power set of H. Why H? Because that is the label used to denote the given set. So how do we make our power set? Simply open brace and then one by one copy all of the subsets you have made. Okay. You may make them closer. Let's make a transparent selection. You can move them closer. Sorry for that. You can move them closer. Yan. Lagay lahat. Okay. Kasama na rin yung tagdalawa. Yun, dito. By the way, let's move it at the bottom. Okay. Since there are 16, make sure that there should be 16 subsets placed as elements of your power set. I believe we will have problem later on in containing all of this. Let's just hope na di siya kayo problem. Okay. We can write it. Let me decrease the size. Yon. Hopefully you can still read them. And then the goal here is just to include everything inside. Yon. I do not know if we could fit everything into one, but we will try. Okay. We will try to fit everything into one. Okay. And finally, the last two sets. Let's fit everything into one. Okay. So let's just have the last one. Sorry. This is how tedious it is to write your power set. So do not forget to always start with subsets so that you will not be repeating the same processes over and over again. Yeah, okay. And then make sure to include the remaining close brace and to separate all way by a comma. Okay, if there are some items that cannot be read properly, we will add them just like this one, D. Okay, and that one. So this is a subset, or this is a power set of the set H containing all subsets. In cases wherein you don't like to use empty set as the last, you may always use null set if you want. So let's count. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 subsets. So again, how do we determine the power set? You may start with the cardinality first using this formula. Using this formula. And then you may proceed to writing unit sets and then increase the numbers until you reach to the set itself and then simply add the null set. Make sure that equal sets should not be written twice because they are just counted once. So this is the last video for module number 2 or lesson number 2. Hopefully you've learned something. Please practice and please do the worksheets tediously. You can do them if you are going to review and ask questions from me from time to time. Thank you very much. See you next time.